is standing on the street. Why? I don't know. Like, despite what a lot of the gurus and self-help folks have you believe, not everything happens for a reason. You're just standing there randomly. And a friend of yours is sitting in a car. And both of you are at rest. There is no disagreement in the universe. There's a lot of peace. But then your friend starts moving. And you go, hey, you know what? You're moving. I'm at rest. And things would have been fine if your friend agreed with you. But unfortunately, your friend does not. He says, you know what? I'm the one at rest. It's you who's moving backwards. Now, the question you're going to think about is, who's right here? Is one of the two of them right? Are you right? Is he right? Are both of you right? Are none of you right? Now, the answer to this question is going to take us on a ride in this episode. And let's see what you learn at the end of it. Did you discuss it? You're saying you're at rest. Your friend is saying he's at rest. Now, your argument to your friend, the story continues, is, you know what? This is just stupid. Look at me. I'm on the ground, right? The ground, the roads, the buildings, the trees. We're all at rest. Why is this even a question? And your friend looks at you and he goes, you're so arrogant, aren't you? Assuming that the ground, the buildings, the trees, all of these are at rest. This is what our ancestors did for thousands of years. They believed that we were at the center of the entire universe and we were at rest. Special. The earth is special. We are the center of everything that ever existed and we're not moving. This is what we believed until the telescope was discovered and Galileo actually saw that things were going around Jupiter, the moons of Jupiter. He discovered them. And it's not a big deal now, but it was a huge deal back then because that meant we weren't as special as we thought we were. Things were revolving around other things. And the good thing about life is that the moment you question one thing, you question more and more. And over the years, as we could see more, we've now realized that we're definitely not the center of the universe. We're not even the center of the current galaxy that we're in. We're in some left edge of it. And this galaxy is just one among the 125 billion galaxies that are there in the universe that we can observe. And not just that, even within our solar system, we're not the center, we're not special. We're just the third unremarkable planet that's going around a somewhat average star that we call our sun. Now, to really get a grasp of this, right? What's this picture taken by Voyager on Feb 14th, 1990, as it was leaving the solar system? It turned back and took a picture. And what's this video by Carl Sagan as he talks about what he calls that little speck that's Earth? He calls it the pale blue dot.
From this distant vantage point, the Earth might not seem of any particular interest. But for us, it's different. Consider again that dot. That's here. That's home. That's us. On it, everyone you love, everyone you know, everyone you ever heard of, every human being who ever was, lived out their lives. The aggregate of our joy and suffering, thousands of confident religions, ideologies, and economic doctrines, every hunter and forager, every hero and coward, every creator and destroyer of civilization, every king and peasant, every young couple in love, every mother and father, hopeful child, inventor and explorer, every teacher of morals, every corrupt politician, every superstar, every supreme leader, every saint and sinner in the history of our species lived there, on the mote of dust, suspended in a sunbeam.
That video almost brings a tear to my eye each time I watch it. Now, that dot that you saw, the pale blue dot, as Carl Sagan calls it, is the Earth. And although we all assume and behave as if the Earth is at rest, that little dot is not at rest. It's actually going through space at a speed of 1 lakh kilometers per hour, as I told you earlier. And the solar system that it's a part of, the sun, is going around the galaxy at 8 lakh kilometers per hour. And it's gonna take like 230 million years for the sun to go around the galaxy once, even at that speed. And the galaxy itself is hurtling towards space at some more than 20 lakh kilometers per hour. So what's the point I'm making here? The point is that in some sense, everything is moving. And it's impossible, actually, to go find, you know, some point in the universe from which, you know, that's at rest and now I can go stand there and say from there I'm going to see who's moving and who's not moving. And that's what's correct. There is no such point. In some sense, the universe is like a balloon that's expanding, and every point is getting further and further away from each other on the surface of that balloon. And you can't actually go find a point on that surface of that balloon that's actually at rest from which everything's expanding. No, no point is special. Every point is equal and moving further away from each other. That's the 2D version, of course. If you can imagine the 3D version of this, that's pretty much our universe. So asking this question, right, who's actually moving and who's actually at rest is a meaningless one. What's meaningful is who's moving from some point of view. I'll tell you what I mean. From your point of view, you can assume you're at rest and say, you know what, I'm at rest, my friend is moving in the car. But your friend, from his point of view, can say, you know what, I'm at rest and you're the one going backwards. And both of you are correct. Everyone has the right to say, hey, I'm at rest, and then look at what's moving and what's not moving from their point of view. So the next time you're, say, in a car, you're going really fast, you look around and you see that there is another car coming next to you. If you feel like that car is coming at the same speed and both of you are at rest, you can say that. You can say, you know what, I'm going to assume I'm at rest, and from my point of view, this car is at rest. And you will not be wrong. If you're in a flight and if you're feeling like, you know, for all practical purposes, even though I know somewhere that I'm going at 800 kilometers per hour with respect to the Earth, I feel like I'm at rest. I'm going to assume I'm at rest for convenience. You can do that. You're right. Because that's actually what we do. We pick the point of view that's convenient for us and then look at who's moving and not moving from that point of view. And that point of view can be anything, except that most of the times on Earth, we assume the point of view of the Earth. We stick a point of view to the ground and then we look at it from the ground's, the Earth's perspective. Which is why when we say that car is going at 100 kilometers per hour, we don't also mention with respect to the Earth. If you keep saying with respect to the Earth, with respect to the Earth, we'll all get bored, so we don't say it. But it's good for you to remember in the back of your mind that that's what we are really doing. So the most important thing for you to remember is that motion is relative. That's what we call it. It's relative basically means that it's only meaningful when you tell from whose point of view you're talking. So the next time you hear somebody is moving, I want you to have a question in the back of your mind. From whose point of view?